So your host for today, it is myself. I'm Mariah. I'm a product specialist at Unito.
And my name is Fanny. I'm a customer success manager.
All right. So tool overflow can leave organizations feeling disjointed and siloed. So maybe you have teams working in a CRM or a tech tool or a PM tool, but the information is feeling a little disorganized. These silos can cause a ripple effect across your teams. So maybe the sales team is spending key selling time in internal meetings and status updates. Maybe the product team is using a specialized tool for developers, causing information to stay trapped there. Or maybe marketing is missing key roadmap information from product, causing delays and confusion. These ripple effects can look like a lot of things, but these are some common pain points we see for sure. It boils down to your teams aren't aligned, the visibility into work is lost, the collaboration between your team stagnates, and you lose time and, you know, as a result, money trying to piece everything together. With Unito, we allow you to break down your tool barriers, gain visibility into that work, align your teams, and save tons of time and effort. And it looks organized just like that. So how does the product work? This is the fun part. I'm going to pass it over to my friend Fanny, who's going to walk us through a demo.
So this is the workflow I've set up in Unito. So jumping to Asana, this is a replica of our project actually called Product Quality Queue. And the way it works is the support team, when finding a bug, would find it here under new requests. Then our project managers, pretty much on an everyday basis, would jump in here to triage the tickets, probably place it in the evaluation phase to start with. And when they're ready to hand it off to the devs, they would move it to the column hand off to devs. And more importantly, they would open the task and add a label with the name of the repository that they want to send it to in GitHub. This is going to be our trigger for Unito to create a corresponding issue in GitHub. And then further down, I'm just going to make a little comment just to show you later on that comments are syncing back and forth. I'm also going to highlight one of the fields called GitHub state. This is a custom field I've created in Asana. And I just want to show you this because it's going to help our project managers keep track of where an issue is at in GitHub. You will know when your Asana task is synced to GitHub because it will say in the description of the task, this task is synchronized with this GitHub issue. And you can actually click on these words, GitHub issue, to take you to the corresponding GitHub issue, which is what I'm doing now. So here it is. Unito created it, and you can see that the comment I made in Asana synced to GitHub. Now, the idea is the devs would start commenting back, right? So I'm just going to add a comment in GitHub, and we'll switch back to Asana. I'm just going to pause here for a sec. You can tell that while we're looking at GitHub, the issue number synced back to Asana. This is just optional. I've set my flow this way, but it's quite convenient for the product team and the development team to refer to an issue if everyone knows what issue number it is in GitHub. So I'm syncing it back to Asana. And then in a sec, you'll see that the field called GitHub state, well, actually it happened already. It has been set to in progress because we started to work on it in GitHub. And then finally, you can see the comments I made in GitHub synced back to Asana. So my comments are really going back and forth, which is really key when it comes to collaboration. Now, what comes next? Well, the devs would eventually close the issue when they're done working on this issue. And what's going to happen in Asana when we do this is the field called GitHub state is going to switch from in progress to released. You can see it here. And I could have set it up so that automatically my task in Asana goes to the completed column. That would make sense, right? But the way we do it at Unito is project managers would actually want to run a few tests before completing a task entirely because we want to make sure a fix is successful, right? So we're running this test and then we're moving the task manually to the completed column. And this is where the flow between Asana and GitHub ends. But I just want to show you a little bonus as well. What we do when we move a task to the completed column is we use an Asana rule to comment on the task. And you'll see, it'll say, this has been released, right? And then We use Unito to push this to a Slack channel for the entire company to see. So the Asana task called "This is a bug" has been posted to our Slack channel. And you can see in the comments that this has been released so that everyone knows a resolution was found for this bug. Just to sum it up, before this workflow was set up, our engineers needed to manually update a task in Asana, and they would sometimes forget to do so, right? We're only human, which means project managers had to poke our engineers to constantly get an update on the status of a task. And you can imagine how frustrating it was for both parties. So now that we've got this in place, tickets in Asana are automatically updated based on what's done in GitHub. Both teams can remain in their preferred tool, which means that we're actually saving on seats as well, right? And the most important updates, as I just demonstrated, are even pushed to Slack for the entire company to see.